yeses and nos. They've been putting Clodhoppers on the radio. No one recognized me, I was incognito. Now I need disguises so my cover won't be blown. Say, has anybody seen my glasses and nose? I don't want to be on TV where my face will show. Say, has anybody seen my witness protection programs? Anybody seen my disguise? Oh, thank you, everybody, especially Alice Lake. Welcome to Clodhoppers, everybody. I'm Clod Headgate. Every so often, we like to make a movie about what's going on down here at Clodhoppers. We've got Alice Lake running all the cameras, John Ho's directing and running the switcher, and, of course, Bo Peep on sound, character generator, and sound effects. And tonight, an extra special treat, ladies and gentlemen. Tonight, I repeat, tonight I am not going to play my accordion. Yay! My goodness. Time to get the tools out. Well, here's a little parody off the CD Volume 1. Parodies Volume 1. CD. Run Amok Records. I was riding my moped. A Honda 50 pulled up and we didn't see a cop. We revved up our engines. It was drag racer bust. That Honda 50 took off and left me in the dust. A little later on, 5 minutes passed. I saw a librarian and wearing glasses. I offered her a ride. I tried to carry her books. A computer geek showed up and gave me one of them dirty looks. Should have been me with that real smart chick. Should have been me with that real smart chick. Should have been me being her chaperone. Corner was this real sharp looking dude. He had on a blue polyester suit and white patent leather shoes. He was parked in front of a restaurant in a Rambler made by Nash. The owner came up and said, "Hey dude, if you leave, I'll give you some cash." Should have been me with that real sharp dude. Should have been me wearing that polyester suit. Should have been a salad, well, you know, I felt okay. Then I passed by a McDonald's cafe. I saw a man eating one of them jumbo Big Macs. Just watching him eat it, give me one of them heart attacks. Expectations. The original song, of course, had T-bone steaks and Buick Dynaflows. Mine has mopeds and cheeseburgers. Well, by golly, shout out to Andy from San Mateo. Been quite a while since we heard from Andy. Since the KFOK radio shows kind of gone off the air. I haven't heard much from Andy, but we did hear from him and giving him a shout out. He's checking us out on the internet now on TV, and he loves to set up his drums and play along with us. And
He is familiar with the artist that does this next song, Rodney Foster. So this goes out to Andy from San Mateo. Thank you, all you swingers out there, by golly. And we're going to get over here and do one by myself. And he also requested that we do this one. He calls it the Generation Song. But first, I'm a little teapot, short and stout. Here is my handle. Oh, rats, I'm a sugar bowl.
Meetings came and went.
Generation song. The song's real name is I Remember. Well, we got stuff going on. We got parodies. We got originals. Oh, I see what's going on here. I was already on the right one. Here we go. This one was worn out on the jukebox down at Harry's in Pismo Beach. If you listen to Mark and Brian at all, you know about Harry's in Pismo Beach. I was house man there for several years. And this is the flip side of my 45, the Milwaukee Tumor that we had out back in those days.
Thank you.
Different arrangement than was on the 45, but I like the new one better, actually. Had real live musicians on the other ones. I made all this stuff myself. Well, shoot. You hear about the Alice Lake's giving us 10. We're doing a great job. For lack of a better person to pick on, we'll pick on blondes here for a minute. Did you hear about the blonde that her car was missing and wasn't running right, so she took it into the shop, and the mechanic fiddled around with it, and pretty soon it was running nice and smooth, and she said, what's going on? And he said, oh, crap in the carburetor, and she said, how often do I have to do that?
Soldiers
Oh, thanks, kids. A little song there by Sawyer Brown for you. One of them true songs. Well, I heard this next one on the radio the other day, and it was not quite the shuffle arrangement that I have for it. It wasn't the original. Of course, the original was done by the guy who didn't play Zorro. Guy Mitchell recorded the song. Guy Williams played Zorro. We wouldn't want to get the wrong guy.
Every day you love me less, each day I love you more.
Oh, thank you, Swingers. All righty. Well, we better get back over here to that parody set and make fun of that Willie Nelson song. But first, the blonde was playing Trivial Pursuit, and the question came up, what would happen if you were in a vacuum and someone spoke to you? Would there be a sound or not? And the blonde asked the question, is it running or not? Thanks for checking out Clodhoppers, everybody. We'll see you again next time. Alice Lake, John Hose, and Bo Peep.
On the phone again. Just can't wait to get on the phone again. The life she loves is making gossip with her friends. She just can't wait to get on the phone. Yak, 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 and will it never end? On an amber room and one on her side of the bed. She just can't wait to get on the phone again. On the phone again. Busy signals all you ever can hear. Calling all her friends. Dial tone something that you won't hear. What you will hear is her on the phone again.
And now, another fact of Congress.
Ever hear somebody stating a supposed fact when you know there has to be another side to the story? Well, getting to the truth quite often means that you have to take the time to go beyond one person's opinion and dig around for what others have to say about it. When you hear about an issue or law that you're really interested in, take the time to find out what the other side thinks about it. You may learn some things you hadn't thought of before, and then you can weigh all of that information and come up with your own opinion. Analyzing all the facts and opinions not only makes you a better informed citizen, it might give you an idea of how you can help. That helps make you a great citizen.
This fact of Congress is a journey.